Hello students, I am Mrs. Sonali and I will be your biology teacher for this session. So this will be your book, grade 7th. This will be your book for biology this session, and these are the contents in your book. Okay, total there are 7 chapters, but for UT we just have to cover chapter number 1, and that is your plant tissues. Okay, so we will start discussing about the plant tissues, but first we need to know what is the meaning of tissues. Okay, you all know that cell, like a house, is made up of bricks. Okay, so our human body is also made up of little cells. Okay, small cells, like a house is made up of bricks. Okay, so our human body is made up of cells. Okay, so cell, you have read it in grade 6 that cell is the structural and functional unit of life, of human being. Okay, so this is the structural unit of cell, is the structural unit of and functional unit of life. Okay, now comes the tissues. Okay, so what are tissues? When a group of cells together form a specific function, okay, when a group of cells together form a specific function, they are known as tissues. Jab ek group of cell, jab bahut sare cells milke ek specific function ko form karte hain, so that is termed as your tissue. So then first comes your cells, okay, then all the cells, all a group of cells then join together to make a perform a specific function, that is known as tissues. Okay, tissues. Now tissues come together, join together and forms the organ. Okay, like our kidney, lung, hand, legs, stomach, these all are our organs. Okay, so the tissues comes together and forms the organs. This all you have studied in grade 6th. Okay, now the organs together, join together, okay, our stomach, our kidney, our lungs, they all are joining together and forming us, the organ system. Okay, so your digestive system, your nervous system, your skeletal system, these all are your organ systems. Okay, so the organs together form the organ system. You just have to make it clear. Okay, cells, the basic and structural and functional unit of life. Then the cells together make up the tissues. They perform a specific function. Then all the tissues, they join together to make organs. Okay, and all the organs, the specific organs, they join together to form an organ system. Okay, this much is clear to everyone. Cells, then tissues, then organ, and then the organ system. So the tissues, now comes our topic, tissues. Okay, so the tissues are present in plants as well as animal. So in this chapter we will discuss about the tissues present in plants. Okay, so we will discuss about plant tissues. Understood? Okay, so now the plant body, in a plant body the tissues are present. Those tissues are divided into two main categories. Okay, plant tissues are divided into two main categories. They are meristematic tissues, meristematic tissues, and the second one is permanent tissues. Okay, so the first one is the meristematic tissues and the next one is the permanent tissues. Understood this much? The plant tissues are divided into two main categories. First one is the meristematic tissue and next one is the permanent tissues. Okay, so what are meristematic tissues? Okay, you must have seen, if you are growing a small plant, okay, you are planting a small plant, does it remain the same in the size throughout its life? No. Okay, it grows up to be a big tree. Okay, it grows up to be a big tree. Okay, so how it is growing? It is because of the meristematic tissues. Okay, so what are meristematic tissues? In which the cells keep on dividing. The cells keep on dividing. So since they are dividing, they are helping in the growth of the plant. Okay, so meristematic tissues, what are meristematic tissue? In which the cells keep on dividing. Okay, since cells are dividing, so they are helping in the growth of the plant. Now what is permanent tissue? What are permanent tissues? Now permanent tissues, those meristematic tissues which were dividing and dividing and dividing, they were helping in the growth. Okay, now those meristematic tissues, now they have stopped dividing. Okay, and they have started performing a specific function. Now they have stopped dividing and they have started performing a specific function, that is known as your permanent tissue. Okay, so permanent tissue, what is the main characteristic of permanent tissue? That it cannot divide. Now it is performing a specific function and the cells are not dividing. Okay, so this is the main difference between meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. So permanent tissue, the cells do not divide. Why the cells are not dividing? Because they have started performing a specific function. The meristematic tissues which have stopped dividing, they have turned into the permanent tissue. Now we will go to the further classification. Okay, now comes the classification of meristematic tissue. In this chapter we will study about the classification of meristematic tissue as well as the permanent tissue. Okay, so now comes the classification of meristematic tissues, the cells in the tissues in which the cells keep on dividing. Okay, so the meristematic tissues are of three types. The meristematic tissues are of three types. Okay, the first one is apical meristem. The first one is apical meristem. Okay, the second one is lateral meristem. You have to pronounce it correctly. Okay, the second one is lateral meristem. The lateral meristem. Okay, now the third one is intercalary. Intercalary meristem. Okay, the first one is apical meristem, next one is lateral meristem, and the third one is intercalary meristem. Okay, now what are the function of these three meristems? Okay, so apical meristem, now we will talk about first apical meristem. So apical meristem, you must have seen, how does a plant grow? Okay, how does a plant grow? Through the stems, through the leaves, or through the roots. Okay, so the apical meristem is present at the top of the growing parts of the leaves, stem or roots. Okay, so apical meristem, it helps in the increase in length of the plant. Okay, increase in length of the plant. If anyone asks you which tissue helps in the increase in the length of the plant, that is your apical meristematic tissue. Okay, and apical meristem, where they are present? At the growing tips. Okay, where they are present? They are present at the growing tips of plant, like the growing tips of stem, the growing tips of root, the growing tips of leaves. Now next one is your lateral meristem. Okay, so lateral meristem, what is the function of lateral meristem? Agar length ki baat aati hai, then growth in length is due to the apical meristem. If it comes about diameter, diameter mein bhi to increase hota hai, does the stem remains the same? No, it turns into a thick bark. Okay, so the bark, the diameter. Okay, so if there is a growth in diameter, it is just because of the lateral meristem. Okay, so lateral meristem brings about growth or increase in diameter of the plant. Okay, it is growing in, growth in diameter of the plant. And where is it present? It is present beneath the bark. Okay, because it is increasing the diameter of the bark, so it is present beneath the bark of the tree. understood this much? Now comes your intercalary meristem. Okay, so this is your intercalary meristem. Okay, so intercalary meristem, it is growth in diameter, growth in length of the plant, growth in diameter of the plant. But plant organs also increases. Okay, leaves itni choti rehti hai, does they remain of the that young leaf size? No, the leaves also grow, the stems also grow. Okay, so if there is a if there is a discussion about the growth in the plant organs or increase in the plant organs, okay, so increase in the length of plant organs, this is because of the intercalary meristem. This is because of intercalary meristem. Okay, and now where they are present, leaves कहाँ से आती हैं? They come from a node of the stem. Okay, जहाँ पे से भी कोई नया plant organ arise होता है plant में, that is known as your node. और दो nodes के बीच में जो जगह होती है, that is called your internode. Okay, so it is present at nodes or internodes of the plant. Okay, nodes or internodes of the So these are the classification of your meristematic tissue. Understood? If you want to take the screenshot to understand it in easy language, you can take it. You have 2 minutes. Done? So we have discussed about the classification of meristematic tissues. Okay, now comes your structure of meristematic. So some points you have to keep in mind. We have studied about apical, lateral and intercalary meristem, but what about the structure of meristematic tissues? Okay, so first one is the meristematic tissues are very small in size. They are very tiny in size and they can be spherical, they can be longitudinal and they can be oval in shape. Okay, they are very small in size, they are very tiny in size and they can be longitudinal, spherical or oval in shape. Then comes about their cell wall. Okay, so cell wall, it is a very thin cell wall which is present in meristematic tissue. Okay, next one is your, they are compactly arranged together. Okay, if they are cells, then they are joined together in a very rigid, tightly form. Okay, so the cells are compactly arranged in meristematic tissues. Then each cell has a large nucleus. Okay, each cell has a large nucleus in between. Okay, but vacuoles are absent in meristematic tissue. So these structure, the main points of the structure you have to keep in mind. And the next thing is function. So we have done it earlier. What is the function of meristematic tissue? Cells keep on dividing and form new cells. So this is your function of meristematic tissue. And here your topic of meristematic tissue ends. Now the another classification of plant tissue. Now we have done about the meristematic tissue. Okay, now comes your permanent tissue. Now we will do the classification of permanent tissues. Okay, so first of all, what are permanent tissues? We have discussed it earlier. Okay, what are permanent tissues? Permanent tissues are those tissues in which cells have stopped dividing and started to perform a specific function. Understood this much? The cells are not dividing. Okay, so if cells are not dividing, their shape will not change. Okay, so permanent tissues have a definite shape. Like meristematic tissues, they were different in size. They may be spherical, they may be longitudinal, or they may be oval. But in permanent tissues, they have a definite shape because the cells are not dividing. Okay, in meristematic tissue, vacuoles were not present, but in permanent tissue, vacuole is present. Okay, there was a huge cytoplasm in meristematic tissue, but in permanent tissue, the cytoplasm is less, and the cell wall can be thin or thick. Okay, according to the circumstances. This is about your structure of permanent tissue. Now comes your classification of permanent tissue. So permanent tissue can be divided into two again. Okay, so first one is simple permanent tissues. Okay, simple permanent tissues and complex permanent tissues. So first let us understand the difference between the two, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Okay, so simple permanent tissue, this type of tissue consists of only one type of cell. This is a simple permanent, so it consists of only one type of cell. Only one type of cell is present. Okay, and the complex permanent tissue, it consists of different types of cells. Here is only one type of cell, but it consists of different type of cells. Understood? In simple permanent tissue, the cells are actively dividing. So, they are living in nature. Okay? So, they are actively dividing cells or living cells. But in complex permanent tissue, the cells have become dead. Okay? So, they are not dividing. They have become dead in nature. This is your second point of difference. Now comes the third point. Simple permanent tissue, you can find it out throughout the plant body. Okay, so it is found out throughout the body. Throughout the body. But complex permanent tissues, they are found only at restricted positions. Okay, and they are found mainly at the vascular tissue. So, vascular tissue, two tissues are present there. They are mainly found at the vascular borders. Okay, so two tissues are there that we will discuss later. So this is your points of differences between simple permanent and complex permanent tissue. So we have done the difference between simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue, and this is all for today. Okay, so for this YouTube session, this much is all. We will further read the classification of simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue in the next video. Till then, keep revising. Okay, please revise all the details given in the session. Thank you.